Hello children, today we will study a very familiar topic, food and its sources. I know everybody of you knows many things about food, like we all are the living things and we need food to survive. We also know that plants and animals both need food. We are known to different plant parts which we use as food. And we also know that all the animals, they eat different types of foods, okay? So in this video, we will put some light on the further topics. For example, components of food, food resources, and energy flow in nature. Okay. So we will start with these learning objectives. First of all, we will study about importance of food. Why do we need food? Then we will study the food which we obtain from different sources like plants and animals. Then we are going to study about food habits of animals. Okay? And lastly, but not the least, we will study the energy flow in nature. Okay? So now we will study these topics one by one. First of all, we will start with need of food. We need to know what is the need of the food. Okay, so this is not very unknown to everybody. We see that we always have staple foods 3 times a day. Everybody know about breakfast, lunch and dinner. Okay. We need to think about why are we getting this food 3 times a day. So as it is written, also I have written for you that all the cars or the vehicles, they need fuel. Once the petrol or the diesel of the vehicle is finished, we need to put some more into it. Why do we need that fuel? To run that vehicle. Similarly, all the animals, or we should say all the living organisms, they need food to get energy for their growth and to stay fit always. Okay, food has some substances in it which are called as the nutrients. We will study about them later on. Okay, so nutrients are present in the food which provides us energy. They help us to grow and they also helps us to stay fit. Okay. So there are certain important functions which food provides to us. So first of all, it gives energy to do various day-to-day activities. It helps in promoting the growth of the body. When a cell is dead, it needs to be replaced. Or when it is worn out, it needs to be repaired. So that is also done with the help of food. Food, the different vitamins and minerals, they protect us from various diseases. Okay, now I used a word called staple. So what is a staple food? Food items that we eat in major portions on daily basis, like the grains, wheat, rice, they all are the staple foods. And you know what? Food is needed even at the time when we sleep. You know about dinner? We always have to have dinner, because when we sleep also, many body activities, they continue inside, and hence the energy is required for them. Okay, so let's discuss the further topics. Now we will talk about sources of food. You see, we eat a variety of food items. Okay, human beings also, if we take example, the human beings also eat different types of food as per their taste, their lifestyle, their habits, needs, availability, etc. Some people eat food items made from rice mainly, for example idli, dosa, while other people, they eat the food which is made from wheat. Okay, so whenever there is a preparation of food which is served as a part of main meal, that is called as a dish. Okay, and all the dishes are made from one or more food items, and those are called as the ingredients. Okay, the ingredients, when we cook food, we mix the ingredients in proper amounts and then we prepare different dishes. Okay, so have you ever wondered when we prepare any kind of dish, we are using different ingredients. Have you ever thought about their sources? Yes, so that there comes the topic of sources. Okay, so just source, the sources are mainly plants and animals. Human beings are consumers, they are heterotrophs, and all the animals are also heterotrophs. So they cannot make their own food, so they get the ingredients to cook their food from plants and animals. From the picture, we will elaborate the food from plants. First of all, see the carrot. Which part is this? This is the root of the plant. Okay. Some other foods like radish, turnip, they also store their food in the roots, which becomes modified roots, and hence we eat them in the form of food. On the other hand, if you talk about potato, potato is an underground stem and it is also a stem modification. When the food is stored in the stems, it becomes the modified stem and it is eaten up as food. The other examples are ginger, turmeric, onion. Similarly, if you look at the broccoli and cauliflower, these are the flowers of their plants and we consume them as food. Okay, then coming to the leaves of lettuce. Maybe lettuce you must not have seen, but everybody must have seen the spinach. This spinach we eat as food. And which part is this? These are the leaves. Okay, so some plants, they save their food in the leaves and we eat them as food. Fruits, maximum of the vegetables and fruits that we eat, they are the fruits of their plants and they are consumed as food. If you look at the cereal plants like wheat, pulses, rice, what are these? These are the seeds of their plants. You can see the peas also. In peas also we use the seed of the plant as food. Okay, so that is all about this food from. Now we will discuss the food which we get from animals. Animals are also a great source of variety of food items. You must have seen the non-vegetarian people. Okay, so they are getting many of their food items from the animals. But the vegetarian people also get one thing from the animals. Not one, two. Milk and honey. These are the things we get from the animals and everybody consumes them a lot. Okay, so we will talk about milk. The milk producing animals like cow, buffalo, goat, they are called as the milch animals. Okay, milk and its products are called as dairy products. I hope you guys must be having milk daily in your diet. Great, because milk is a very healthy food. Okay, moving on to egg and meat. The birds like hen, they lay eggs and their eggs are consumed as food. So such kind of birds are called as the poultry birds. Okay, meat is also one of the staple food items that comes from chicken, goat, sheep, ducks, etc. Okay, then seafood and fish. You must be knowing about a variety of seafoods that are eaten up in different parts of the world as food. Fishes are also main component of food in our North India, South India. Okay, then honey. Bees, the honey bees, they collect nectar of the plants. You know the nectar? The sweet scented liquid present in the petals of the flowers. Okay, that nectar is collected by the bees and the bees transform it into a sweet liquid called honey. It's yummy. So it has medicinal properties also. Along with a major food item, it is used in medicine industry also. Okay, so that was about food coming from plants. Now we will be discussing about the food habits of animals. See, we all are variety of animals in this world. Okay, depending upon the food habits, the animals are divided into these major categories which we are going to discuss now. First of all, we will talk about the herbivores. Herbie means plants, okay? So the animals which eat only the plants, for example, cow, goat, sheep, they all are called as the herbivores, okay? They have very sharp cutting front teeth and their back teeth are wide and made for grinding so that they can chew the hard grasses easily and digest them. You must be knowing about many birds. The birds are having hard and pointed beaks to eat the food. The insects like butterflies who feed on the nectar of the plants, they have very special kind of mouth parts. They are given straw-like mouth parts by nature and these mouth parts are called as the proboscis. The proboscis helps them to suck the nectar of the plants. Okay. Now we will talk about the carnivores. Animals that eat only flesh of other animals like lion, leopard, tiger. Okay. Their teeth are very, very strong, long, sharp and pointed because they need to tear the flesh of the other animals. Okay. There are other animals like frog also, they are carnivores but they eat insects. So it catches its food with the help of a long sticky tongue, okay, which is folded inside its mouth. Whenever an insect comes around, it just open up and it projects its tongue towards the insect and catch the insects very easily. Now we will talk about omnivores. The word omni means both. Yes, animals that eat both plants and flesh of other animals are called as the omnivores, like human beings and dogs, crow, etc. Okay, now there are some special categories of animals. Okay, we will discuss them one by one. First of all, we will talk about scavengers. You must have seen a group of eagles or vultures around a dead body of animals. Many a times, many of you must have seen. So these are the animals or birds that feed on the flesh of already dead animals. For example, fox, hyena, vulture, crow, eagle, etc. In this way, what they are doing? They are giving a very important contribution towards cleaning the dead bodies of animals from the environment. Okay. Moving on towards the decomposers. The decomposers are not visible to us generally. Okay. Most of them. Many of them are visible also like fungus and all. Okay. So decomposers are microorganisms generally that break down the dead plants and animals and convert them into soil-like particles so that they become simple and the nutrients present in them becomes available for the soil once again. Okay, bacteria and fungi are the examples of decomposers. Then we have the parasites. Parasites are the kind of organisms that live in or on the body of the host. They live on or inside the body of the host and get all the food from there only. They generally harm the host. For example, mosquitoes, you must be known to the mosquitoes. Similarly, the leech, hookworm also, they live on or inside the body of the host and get their food. So this was all about the food habits of animals. Moving on towards the energy flow in nature. We have studied that all the organisms, they are dependent upon each other for their different needs. Okay. If we look at the plants, they consume the sunlight and they prepare their own food, right? So they are producers. Animals depend on plants and other animals, so they are consumers. Their interdependence means dependence of on one another can be very easily understood by looking at this picture. You can see here that the plants are able to prepare their food with the help of sunlight, water and minerals taken from the soil. the grasshopper that is eating the plants, you can see here. The mice is eating the grasshopper. The mice is then later on eaten up by the snake. Eagle consumes the snake after that. When the snake is eaten up by the eagle, and the eagle dies after its lifetime is over. The fungus break down the dead body of the eagle into simple substances and turns them into the nutrients. The nutrients are then absorbed by the soil. Once again, these nutrients are available for the plants to be absorbed. So this kind of cyclic behavior is shown by the organisms in nature. Okay, such kind of chain in which energy is flowing from one level to another level, such kind of chains are called as the food chains. We can see many kinds of food chains in nature. Okay, many of these food chains becomes interconnected sometimes, and they becomes the food web. From here we can conclude that the plants are the producers, animals are the consumers, the herbivores like grasshopper, they are the primary consumers, animals eating primary consumers like this mice, they are the secondary consumers. Secondary consumers are in turn eaten up by the tertiary consumers. So this chain goes on and on, and hence tells us that the energy flows in nature from one level to another level. Okay, so this was all about the chapter, children. I hope you guys must have enjoyed and learnt a lot from this. Thank you very much. Thank you very much to all of you.